good, everybody on YouTube? It is your boy Forrest Ripperton back at it again with another video. What is up, everybody? As you can see, I'm back in the crib. I'm back out Maryland right now, y'all. So I'm back from New York, and we explain like why, you know what I'm saying, what's going on in my process, because I got some things to like talk to y'all about. But that's not what we're here for today. We are here because, guys, I made it on Vogue. My picture made it on Vogue along with all the other models that was in the fashion show, y'all. And this is crazy. Like, I don't think y'all understand, bro. Like, okay, I was trying to hold in my excitement and stuff, like, in the beginning when I first found out I made it on the show. And then, you know what I'm saying, while I was in it and all this stuff, I was trying to hold in my excitement. But I guess it's, like, it's time for me to, like, really let it all out, y'all. Like, let it all out, because like I'm so like amped about this, bro. Like, it's so crazy. Like, my picture really made it on Vogue. Like, y'all could see it right here. Let me move all the way over so y'all can just see the picture. Just look at it. Just look at me. I'm on, you see the Vogue at the top, and my face is like right there. That's me, guys. That's me right there. That is so crazy, y'all. Like, I really made it on Vogue, and that is so, like, so exciting. I really, like, it's really crazy what they say, like, a lot can happen in a year, and this year not even over, and I just been, like, grinding, working hard, just keep putting out content, all this other stuff, and I actually, like, really, you know what I'm saying, really did something good, like, something crazy, some things that I asked for, and it's just so amazing, y'all. And a lot of people wanted to, like, ask me, hold on, I'm about to sneeze. Excuse me. Oh, I got another one. No, I don't got another one. Okay, so a lot of people have been asking me, like, how did I do it? So I decided to, like, have this conversation with y'all, make this video about, like, how that happened. Because a lot of people are like, well, how do you become a model, blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, well, I don't really, like, consider myself as a model, you know what I'm saying? I just like taking pictures and stuff like this, because that's what I told everybody. I just really like taking pictures and putting them on Instagram because I like clothes, I like dressing, you know what I'm saying, putting clothes on, taking pictures, looking sweet, looking fly, you know what I'm saying, swaggy all the time. So that's really what I've been doing. So I just want to let y'all know, like, my process of how this whole thing happened and how I ended up on Vogue and in a fashion show. So as y'all know, like, y'all saw, like, my vlogs and stuff like that of, like, what happened and my process of getting up to it. But to take it, like, a little bit back, like, I've always been taking pictures on Instagram, just always putting on outfits, taking pictures, you know what I'm saying, and just looking sweet. And I just been doing that because it's just something that I really like to do. So it was nothing really forced. And when I first started taking pictures and stuff on Instagram, I never did it and was like, all right, I'm gonna do this and this is gonna make me, you know what I'm saying, become a model and all this other stuff. I just genuinely like taking pictures and getting fly. So it was just like an organic thing, and I didn't force it. So with anything in life, I just feel like you should do it organically, because everything else comes easy and it doesn't seem like it's forced. A lot of people give up on stuff that seems forced, and that's why a lot of people don't really like Instagram and like social media, because they feel like it's forced. They don't really like taking outfit pictures. They don't really like putting videos out like that and stuff like that. They feel like it's too much of a like job and a hassle. So I just feel like it was a secondhand nature thing for me. So I just like doing it, and I just kept doing it. I also been doing this YouTube stuff for a long time. I just never really stayed consistent. I wish I had like all my old videos up, because I have so many old videos. But I've been doing YouTube for a long time, and then I stopped doing it, and then just about this year I really started getting really consistent. So all in all, I'm just trying to brand myself and build an awareness around myself, because like you guys know, I make like the clothes and stuff like that. I want my own thrift store, of course, and I also want to make, like, YouTube a living. Like, I want to be able to make this, like, my thing and stuff like that. So I just been going hard, grinding and grinding, trying to stay consistent, because this is really something that I really want. And that's another thing that I want to give you guys advice on, is if it's something you really, 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 really want to do, you got to keep doing this, stay consistent. I've had so many doubts in all of this stuff that I've been doing. Like, YouTube, like I said, I stopped doing YouTube because I was like, man, this is not going anywhere, bro. Like, I'm not getting no subscribers. Nobody is watching my videos. Nothing like that. Like, you're going to doubt so many times with whatever you do, because it's all this. It's always a chance that, dang, what if this doesn't work? But you don't really know if it's going to work if you don't try it. Like, on my Instagram, my last picture that I put up, it said, you miss 100% of the shots that you don't take. So, like, you just never know unless you try it. So I just advise y'all to just try everything that you want to do, no matter how much you think it's just not working, or you're just like, man, this is whatever, nobody likes me. It's nobody was ever good at anything when they first started. So you just got to keep that in mind and just be like, look, I'm not good right now. I'm going to get better as if, like, as I keep going. So I take pictures on Instagram. I do my YouTube thing, and I'm just building that awareness around myself. And I follow Pierre Moss on Instagram already because, like I was telling y'all, I really love the brand. I really love the message that they're trying to put out there to just show, like, first of all, the whole fashion show was all, like, African-American people, so that's amazing. He wanted to, his message is to, you know what I'm saying, portray images that normal people in the fashion industry don't really, you know what I'm saying, do. He wants to put that image out of people who are, you know what I'm saying, people of color, all of that stuff, and people who are looked at as weird and awkward and not like normal, stuff like that. He's just really, really great with messages like that. So that's why I already was following him, because I believed in the vision. And then one day he posted a post saying that open castings were coming. And in my head, I was like, bro, like, I'm not gonna make this. Like, this is an example of, like, me doubting myself. And how me doubting myself and always in my head could have kept me from the greatest opportunity ever. So I was like, bruh, I'm not even going to make this. They're not going to pick me. But then another part of me was just like, bro, like, what do you have to lose? Like, just send them the email, send them the pictures, whatever. Because me, I'm not a sign model. One thing that I felt like I can't model is because I have facial hair. Because I always see models who don't have no facial hair, and it's like clean cut. So I'm like, bro, I still have that feeling now. Like, I still feel like, okay, I did this, but like a lot of people don't really have facial hair like mine who really be modeling. So I still kind of have that doubt, but I was like, okay, I have facial hair. I never modeled before. I don't have any professional pics. So what am I going to send them? But all that stuff was going in my head, but I still was like, bro, you have nothing. You literally don't have nothing to lose. So I went to the email, I sent them like a couple of pictures off of my Instagram. If you guys saw my older like videos, like when I first got the notice that I was going to the casting, you guys know the pictures that I chose. But I just gave them some pictures off of my Instagram, and I explained like I'm not a signed model, I've never done this before, anything like that. And I just sent it, like I sent it, and I was waiting forever, guys. Like, I was waiting for like almost a week, and I was like, man, already made up in my mind that I probably didn't make it, because I'm like, okay, the show is on Sunday and it's already Friday right now. Like, I didn't get picked. But then I got, you know what I'm saying, I got picked. They texted me Saturday at 2:30 in the morning or something like that, and I was so amped. And then I went to the castings and I went to like the audition and stuff. I walked for them and everything. And then they called me back, and that's how all of this stuff happened. So it was just like, I didn't really, you know what I'm saying, I didn't really go to any other castings. That was literally my first casting ever. That was really my first everything, like, what modeling, like, I've taken pictures, obviously, but, like, nothing on that scale. So that's really just how it happened, and I don't know where I'm gonna go from this, to be honest, because a lot of people was asking me, like, are you gonna go to more castings and stuff like that, and it's like, I like modeling, but I don't know how I feel about me keep going to different castings and stuff like that. It's like, it's cool. I always tell people I just want the opportunities to just, you know what I'm saying, present itself. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to go out there and like force it. Like, a lot of people, like, it's nothing wrong with people who really want to be models. Like, then you're going to go out and go to castings, find out all this other stuff. Me personally, I just follow a lot of brands that I like that I can see myself modeling for. And then I'm trying to build an awareness around myself, so to where they're like, you know what I'm saying, oh, I need him to, you know what I'm saying, I need him to come to my show because I need that. I don't like feeling like I need somebody else. So that's just my logic with it. I don't like feeling like I need somebody else. So when I go to them, you know what I'm saying, try to model, they're like, oh, well, you're a nobody, da 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 da. Because they're going to treat you a different way. Like, just, this is just pure honesty with any industry. If somebody else feel like you need them, then they're going to go about it a different way. But if you're coming with the leverage and all of that stuff, then it's like, all right, I can't play with him because he already know his worth and stuff like that. So you want to be able, that's just my method. A lot of people, they might not, you know what I'm saying, agree with it or stuff like that. But my all in all is not to be a model. So I'm not going to go about it the same way that people really want to be a model would. I'm trying to, like, build my own brands and, like, build a brand name, like, build an awareness around my name. So that's really what I want to do. But me modeling, that is crazy. Like, this opportunity was crazy, guys. Like, oh my goodness. Like, I'm saying, like, I'm really appreciative of all this stuff. Like, it is so crazy. This gave me a lot of recognition, like, with followers, and a lot of photographers have hit me up, and a lot of models have hit me up and stuff like that. So it's a way for me to connect and network even more. So it's just been an amazing process, y'all. And it just shows that if you really just keep working, fight off that doubt that's in your mind, bro, you will be great. You'll be straight. Like, I literally made it on Vogue. Like, my picture, I've never, bro. If you understand the amount of people that watch Vogue stuff and are all, like, really into fashion, the amount of people that seen that stuff, it's like, okay, you're not the only one up there. Like, I'm not the only one up there. I'm up there with a lot of more models, but I'm up there too. Like, I'm up there. So it's just, like, so crazy. I never thought that I would be able to say that I was on, like, some Vogue stuff that I was in my first actual fashion show. It was so many celebrities there. Lil Keed, I was talking to Lil Keed. He was in the line with me, but we was about to walk. Doja Cat was there. She was modeling too. Brent Faiyaz was there. He was modeling with us as well. At the end of this show, Vic Mensa walked past me. Kalani was literally standing right next to me, talking to the models and talking to us and all that stuff, bro. It was so many celebrities at this joint. Joey Badass, Wale was outside. What's his name? St. John was there. The Migos was there. It was so Alila May. I don't like saying her name wrong. I'm sorry. I know she probably never gonna watch this video, but Alila May, however you say it, she was there. It was literally so many celebrities. Rico Nasty was there. I was on her page. The girl Hennessy, I think that's Cardi B's sister. I was on her page. Bro, like, it was so many celebrities and so many people there, and it was just so amazing, y'all. But I really made it on Vogue. I wanted to make this video to just show y'all and just give y'all, hopefully this gives you guys inspiration to, you know what I'm saying, just go for your dreams and go all in on it and just keep working. Like, I've been working hard for a long time. This is not nothing that just was handed to me. Like, I've really been trying to, you know what I'm saying, build myself up and just keep working and release that doubt. Like, you could do whatever you want to do, bro. So that's why I needed to make this video, because I just wanted to hopefully inspire anybody out there who has dreams but felt like they need to put it on the back burner, or they just feel like they're not good enough. Like, you literally can do whatever you want to do, y'all. Like, literally, this is your world. This is yours. Everything is yours. If you can see it happening, then it's possible. Like, if you can literally see it happen, like, you have dreams of stuff happening and it could be yours, like, can possibly happen. I always said, like, dang, I want to be on the fashion runway. I want to be on the runway. Like, I really want to model like that. And my bad, like, my nose feel running and stuff. But yeah, I've had visions of all this stuff. So it's just like, I just made it happen because I just never gave up. Just keep consistently working. So I just hope this serves as inspiration for you guys. And I'm really appreciative once again. Like, this is a great experience, and I just really want to thank everybody who's been supporting me. Literally, like, I literally couldn't do this without you guys. Like, I keep saying that this is not just me, all my supporters, everybody who's been supporting me and all of that stuff. I literally couldn't do this without y'all. Like, if I was doing this on my own, it was just me, like, no way. Like, it's all y'all, and I really am appreciative of all you guys. And I just want to thank everybody who's supporting me and continues to support me every day and all of that. Like, y'all are the real GOAT. So yeah, I just wanted to use this video as inspiration, and I hope you guys chase your dreams and never give up, man. Like, for real. So I just want to thank y'all for watching the video, and stay tuned to my other videos. Like I said, I'm gonna be dropping videos. I'm consistent with it, so let's get it. Tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend to come, you know what I'm saying, join the family, man. We just one big family. So I'll see y'all next video. It's your boy Forrest Ripperton. And if you have any other questions or anything about, like, how I did it or what to do and stuff like that, you can DM me, say it in the comments below, all of that. I will gladly answer your questions. So, it's your boy Forrest Ripperton, and we are out. You dig? Sheesh.